In this video, I'm going to explain anatomy of coracobrachialis. Coracobrachialis. This muscle is kind of a shoulder muscle. I'm going to explain its origin, insertion, and function. Okay? Origin of coracobrachialis is this part, coracoid process. Coracoid process. Name of this muscle indicates attachment. It's like coraco. This means coracoid process. This part. Okay, then insertion is humerus. Medial part of humerus. Medial part of humerus. Brachialis. Brachium means arm. Humerus, right? So, coracobrachialis, coracoid process, and humerus. Simple enough, right? Now let's look at function of coracobrachialis. It has three functions, okay? One thing is shoulder flexion. Okay, shoulder flexion and adduction. Adduction is this movement, closing arm, okay? Flexion, adduction, and internal rotation. Internal rotation. You know, coracobrachialis is not very famous muscle. However, it can do three movements. That's a lot, right? Flexion, adduction, and internal rotation. And there are two other muscles attached on coracoid process. One muscle is this one, pectoralis minor. Let's say pec minor. Pec minor. And one more muscle is biceps brachii. Let's say biceps. Coracoid process is very tiny structure. And there are three muscles attach on coracoid process. So what can I say about this? If pectoralis minor gets tight, this tightness can affect other two muscles, coracobrachialis and biceps brachii. If coracobrachialis gets tight, this can affect pectoralis minor or biceps brachii. You can say the same thing for biceps. If this muscle gets tight, that affects coracobrachialis and pectoralis minor. Why? Because they share same attachment. Okay, so this is very tiny place. However, it's very important for shoulder girdle muscle and shoulder muscle. In this video, I explained basic anatomy of coracobrachialis, its origin, insertion, and function. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.